Hi, I am Dr. Gudmundsson. This video contains supplemental material intended for my students in my aircraft design classes at Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University, where I currently teach. The video features excerpts from my textbook, General Aviation Aircraft Design, Applied Methods and Procedures, now also available in a Chinese translation. The book is available online from a large number of outlets, including Elsevier and Amazon. It is recommended for anyone interested in the design of general aviation aircraft. Greetings. In this video, I will show you the basics of mission analysis. You can find the details of it in Chapter 6, Section 6.2.3 in the second edition of my book. This is a powerful method that we can use to estimate the initial gross weight of our airplane during the conceptual design phase. Aircraft weight estimation for this purpose requires two distinct procedures. We begin with an initial weight estimation, followed by a secondary weight estimation, also called detailed weight estimation. The initial estimation is hugely important because it yields the initial gross weight. We use it directly and indirectly to estimate the initial wing area, initial tail geometry, and in general, the remaining initial geometry of the aircraft. An accurate initial estimate reduces the number of sizing iterations and thus is highly desirable. Once this initial sizing is completed, the second procedure is applied, detailed weight estimation. This video only focuses on the initial estimation. This chart shows a roadmap to conducting the initial weight estimation. There are two situations to consider. One, either we know the gross weight in advance, or two, we do not. With respect to the first one, occasionally there are situations in which we know the gross weight in advance. For example, 14 CFR Part 1.1 dictates that LSA aircraft must have a maximum gross weight of 1,320 pounds if land plane and 1,430 pounds if amphibious. In that situation, it makes a lot of sense to just use these as the gross weight. There may also be situations in which we designate the gross weight of a rival aircraft as the target gross weight of our airplane. Both call for the use of initial weight estimation method too. Most often, however, the gross weight is not known in advance. For this situation, we resort to methods 1 and 3. The designer should apply both methods to this situation and evaluate the significance of different predictions they are likely to return. I contend that methods 1 and 2 are simple to understand and apply. It should suffice to read the appropriate sections in the book. Method 3, in contrast, is more complicated and thus warrants a demonstration. This is best accomplished using an example, such as the one that I will now show. A jet-powered unmanned aerial vehicle, UAV, is being designed to fly a 150 nautical mile distance. The design mission is shown with estimated weight ratios for each segment. There is no requirement made for reserve fuel. The payload is 150 pounds and the empty weight ratio is 0.55. First note that the entire mission is represented using segments connected using points we call nodes. The segment from node 0 to 1 represents engine startup, taxi into takeoff position, and subsequent takeoff. The next segment from node 1 to 2 represents climb to cruise altitude. This is followed by segment from node 2 to 3 that represents cruise, and so on. The weight ratios shown represent how the weight of the airplane changes as it moves from node to node. For instance, if our aircraft weighs 1,000 pounds at node 0, in this example, then it will weigh 990 pounds at node 1. This weight change is caused by fuel consumption, but could just as well be accompanied by additional weight being discharged from the airplane. For instance, a military aircraft dropping ordnance, a firefighting aircraft dropping fire retardant, or parachutists exiting the airplane. Now, for this example, we know that the weight of the airplane at node 0 is the sum of the empty weight, W sub E, plus payload, W sub P, plus fuel weight, W sub F. This could easily be a representation for the design gross weight of the airplane, and this is what we assume in this example. Then, let's assume that once the aircraft reaches node 5, all usable fuel has been consumed. Therefore, the weight of the airplane changes from the gross weight at node 0 to its weight at node 5, that consists solely of the aircraft's empty weight and payload. At this point, we do not know the weight at any of the nodes 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, but one of our goals is to be able to specify this. Right now, W0 is unknown. However, if we knew it, we could use it to calculate the weight at node 1, as shown. We simply multiply W0 by the weight ratio associated with the segment between nodes 0 and 1. Once we have W1, we can proceed to node 2 and calculate W2 in the same fashion. W2 is the product of the weight at node 1 and the weight ratio along the segment between nodes 1 and 2. Note that we can also write this in terms of the weight at node 0, W0. We do this by taking advantage of how W1 is calculated. To get W2, we multiply the weight ratio W2 by W1 by the product from the previous step, here shown in red. Then let's proceed in this fashion for the remaining segments. This means that we can represent the node at the end of mission, node 5, as the weight of the aircraft at node 0 multiplied by the chain of all the weight ratios. Now let's move this result over here for clarity and take a closer look. Recall we already know what the weight should be at node 5, namely it should equal the empty weight plus the payload. Let's write this explicitly here. We cannot divide through this equation by W0. Note how this generates two additional weight ratios, the empty weight ratio and the payload weight ratio. Next, we can plug and chuck our weight ratios and payload as shown. The product of the weight ratios returns 0.6588, and this must equal the empty weight ratio of 0.55 plus the unknown payload ratio, given by 150 pounds divided by W0. Let's move it over here and solve for W0. Solving for W0 shows that the gross weight of our UAV should be 1,379 pounds. Thus, we can calculate the empty weight by simply multiplying this weight by the empty weight ratio of 0.55. This gives an empty weight of 758 pounds. Then, we can also figure out the required fuel weight. It is simply the gross weight minus the empty weight minus the payload. This gives a required fuel weight of about 471 pounds for our design mission. This corresponds to about 70 US gallons of Jet A1. Volumetrically, that corresponds to space in excess of one large bathtub of fuel. Using that analogy helps us envision how much internal volume to carry that fuel our aircraft must provide. Alrighty then, I hope this helps you develop a sense of how mission analysis can help you size your airplane by providing an understanding of its gross, empty, and fuel weights given the specific payload. It can also be adapted to electric aircraft using kilowatt hours of energy rather than fuel weight. Finally this, there are at least three questions that this may engender. First, is there a shorter way to write the product of all the weight ratios? Our mission here is super simple. Many missions require a long chain of weight ratios, making this form unwieldy. The answer is yes, and we do this using the product symbol, capital Pi, as shown here. The second question is, how do we calculate the weight at each node? We start with the weight ratio at end of mission, W sub n divided by W0. Let's designate the node of interest using a lowercase n. Thus, for node n, this becomes... Then we solve for W sub n, as shown here. As an example, consider we want to determine the weight of the aircraft at end of cruise, node 3. This requires the gross weight to be multiplied by the chain of weight ratios up to and including node 3. substituting the appropriate weight ratios and multiplying returns a weight of 927 pounds. Also note the weight at each note is shown, calculated using this approach. The third and last question is, how do we know the weight ratios? Admittedly, I pulled the weight ratios in this example out of thin air, excuse the pun. In real applications, these are obtained using a careful evaluation. I provide all the necessary equations for this purpose in the second edition of my book, both for jets and propeller aircraft. For instance, the empty weight ratios can be obtained from expressions in section 6.2.2. Expect to have to derive similar equations using a narrower range of aircraft than used in these, but they are a great start. The other weight ratios are obtained using the relations in section 6.2.3. These allow you to estimate suitable weight ratios based on number of parameters such as taxi time on the ground, the altitude to which the airplane must climb, the expected specific fuel consumption of the engines, propeller efficiency, desired range or endurance, expected rate of climb and descent, and expected cruise lift to drag ratio. This permits the reader to conduct pretty accurate mission analyses as well as evaluating mission sensitivities. In this capacity, I strongly recommend the reader reviews example 6-4 in the book that demonstrate its application to a Dassault Falcon 900 style aircraft. We have come to the end of this video. Please like and subscribe. Have fun designing.